Good morning, children. How about all of you today? I'm sure you are excited to praise God.
Well, yes, I'm sure you are, children. We missed you for a week. Well, now it's time to have some fun together again. Shall we go, Zippy?
Oh, yes, we should, Effa. Let's go.
Come on, children. Let's go and praise the Lord.
Hello, children. Welcome to another week of virtual lesson. We have some exciting programs to line up for you this week. But before we move on, let's put our hands together, close our eyes, and pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for bringing us into this platform again, Lord. Lord, we pray that you will guide us and give us new knowledge, Lord Father, as we go through this week's lesson. We give you all glory and honor, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, children, are we ready to praise our Lord? Let's go.
To have hope and believe.
Hi children, hope you would have enjoyed the praise and worship segment. Now let's move on to story time. But before that, I would like all of you to remain quiet and pay close attention to the story. Let's go.
Hi children, lesson for this week, the parable of the talent. Let's pray before we start our lesson. Father in heaven, we want to thank you for this day. Lord, as you tell the story, the children will listen, Lord. We put their children in your hands, Father. In Jesus' name I pray, Amen. Jesus told a parable about a wealthy man who was going on a long journey. Before leaving, he met his three servants and told them to take care of his house and money while he was away. He gave his first servant 5 talents, the second servant 2 talents, and the third servant 1 talent. Talent is like money. In olden days, they used talent instead of money. The man was placing great trust on this servant. Each talent cost at least 15,000. He was giving them a lot of money in their hands. He instructed them to invest the money wisely. When the master returned home several months later, he called his servants to give him account of what they did with the talent he gave them. The first servant did very well. He invested the 5 talents he was given and made 5 in the profit. So he handed over 10 talents to his master. The second servant had been given 2 talents and he doubled his money and handed over 4 talents to his master. The master praised and thanked the 2 wise servants. Then the third servant approached his master and handed over the same 1 talent he had been given. "What is this?" the master demanded. "I give you 1 talent and you give me back 1 in return. That's it." The servant replied, "Well, sir, I was afraid that you would be angry if I failed and lost the money. So I did the best thing. I buried it in a field so I could return it to you now, safe and sound." The master was not pleased. He says, "You could have at least put it in the bank and earn a little interest, but I guess you could not be bothered." He then dismissed the servant. The point here is that God has given all of us similar type of talents. Look at the slide for some of the talents God has given us. God expects us to use whatever talent we have be given to serve Him and Him alone. Some of us are very talented, like the first servant who received 5 talents, and some are maybe less talented, more like the second servant who received 2 or maybe even 1. God does not expect all of us to produce like the first servant. God simply asks us to take what we have been given and to use it well. We have come to the end of the story. Let's pray. Loving Father, help me to use the talents that you have given me for good things and to serve you. In Jesus' name, Amen. Bye children. See you next week.
Hi children. Did all of you enjoy the story? I hope you did. Well, we have come to the last segment of our program for today. Yes, that's right. It's memory verse time.
Today's memory verse is Luke 16 verse 10. Luke 16 verse 10. Whoever can be trusted with very little can also be trusted with much. And whoever is dishonest with very little will also be dishonest with much. Luke 16 verse 10. Luke 16 verse 10. Now it's your turn to try it. Have fun. Bye.
Hi children. We have come to the end of our program for this week. We hope you would have enjoyed this week's lesson. We will be back again next week for more exciting programs to line up for you. But before we go, let's put our hands together, close our eyes and pray. Dear Lord, we once again thank you for giving us this opportunity to learn about you more in this virtual lesson. Lord, even as the children go back to school, Lord, we pray for your protection and your guidance from far. We thank you and we give you all glory and honor. Lord, till we meet these children next week, Lord Father, Lord, we pray that your protection be upon them, Lord. We pray that you will surround them with your love, Lord. All this I ask in the most precious name of our Lord and Saviour. Amen. Thank you, children, and bye-bye.
Oh, what fun it was learning the memory words, wasn't it, children?
Zippy, you did not wait for me.
Oh, I'm sorry, Effa. I was so excited to meet the children.
Oh, I am excited to meet them too. But children, it's time to say goodbye till we meet next week again. Bye, children.
Bye, children. Let's go, Effa.